A voice in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his ways. My dear people, as you know, today is the second Sunday of Advent, in the middle of the season. There are four Sundays. Before we know it is over. And today we hear the word of John the Baptist, who comes and really prepare the way before the Messiah, before Jesus. And his words were simple and to the point. Prepare the way of the Lord. If you look at the first reading today, taken from the prophet Baruch, we see that the prophet was sent in a time of very distressful in the life of the chosen people. He was telling them that the promise that God made in the covenant is going to come to be a reality. And although they are going to the exile and their hopes were really vanished, he tells them that now God is going to bring them to their city of Jerusalem. And in fact, he said to them, look at the east. Your children are coming. Those children that were separated and they were taken as exile, or they have to leave town because of the persecution. They are coming and the Lord is going to be in your midst. Yes, you are going to be the one who are going to rejoice. Because you are going to see your enemies walking behind your troops. And that is a shameful scene for those who are defeated, that the enemy walks behind as the triumph troop come to the city. He said to them, remember that the Lord is going to send somebody special. And that somebody special is going to be the one that today's gospel fulfilled, John the Baptist. And he's going to level every road. He's going to prepare the way for the Lord. So when he comes, he makes his throne in the midst of their city. And then we go into the gospel day and we find that promise was fulfilled. When John, according to Luke, he wants to give us a certain time because there was no calendar at that time, but he told us what time it was. It was the time of Tiberius Caesar, who was reigning in the year 15 years. He told us who was the governor of Judea, and he told us about the king of Judea. At that time, John was asked by God to begin preparing the way for the Lord. He went to the Jordan and he was baptizing people and tell them that unless they repent of their own sins and be immersed in the waters to cleanse from their sins as a purification, they cannot be ready for the coming of the Lord. But I'd like to focus today on that second reading, a reading that comes from the heart of a man who loved God, who loved his people, and he was so much in love with our Savior Jesus Christ. I'm speaking about her. Speaking to the people of Philippi, a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful town in the Europe, today is part of Turkey. And we know that these people loved Paul so dearly. They loved him from the moment that he comes to the land of Philippi. And listen to what he said. I pray always with joy in my every prayer for you because of your partnership of the gospel from the first day until now. The question I put to you is, do you pray for each other? Do you pray for the community of St. Anthony? Do you pray for this merger? That's what St. Paul did. When I think of you, he's not thinking of one person, he is thinking of the whole community of Philippi. When I think of you in my prayers, I rejoice. And I pray constantly for you. Because you are with me, and you accept me, and accept the message of the gospel from the first day I step in the land of Philippi. And here we see that St. Paul used the word partnership. If we want the church to succeed, dear people, there is one condition, that all of us will be one in the same message and united with those who come in the name of the Lord to preach his message. Whether we like the person whether our chemistry is like us or not, he is the one who represents Jesus Christ among us. And he comes to us with one important mission, to bring us to God and God to us. That is the most important key of the ministry, of the apostle. And that is very important. Because many times we begin to criticize all kinds of things that the minister is doing or the priest is doing. Little we know that when you point your finger to somebody, there is three fingers pointing to you. First, you need to correct your look, your ways. Because so that you can see clear how you can correct other people's way. And St. Paul said, continue, I am confident of this, that the one who begins this good works in you will continue to bring it to completion until the day of the Lord Jesus. And St. Paul knows that this good thing that they have among them, that they care for each other, that they work together for the proclamation of the word, that they are really of one mind and heart. St. Paul said, I know that what God begins in you by the power of the Holy Spirit that you receive from the waters of baptism, he will bring it to fulfillment on the day of the parousia, on the day when the Lord Jesus will come in his glory to judge the living and the dead. And then he continued, God is my witness. Here St. Paul is making a witness, or he is making a vow, or he is really making an oath, and he bring God as witness. As God is my witness, how I long for you with affection of Jesus Christ. And that is a parent to a child. How many of you, when your child is away, I pray for those mothers whose sons are away because of service, how much during this holiday they wish that their children are among them. And that's what St. Paul said, how much I wish with the affection I have for you, that I am among you. And this is my prayer, that your love may increase ever more and more in the knowledge and every kind of perception to discern what is the value, so that you may be pure and blameless on the day of Christ Jesus. Here again, St. Paul remind them, I know what you are doing, like last Sunday, but I want you to do more. I am not satisfied with good, I want you to be best. It's like a parent said to the child, I know you have an A in your test, but you can be a plus. Why? Because you know the speed of your kid. Sometimes you're a little lazy. If he push himself a little bit more, he can have that A plus. And that's what St. Paul said. I know you are doing good and I am very proud of you. In fact, you are the joy of my ministry. And when I pray for you, I am filled with joy because you are the one that from the first day you accept me and accept my message. But now I ask you to do more.